Hello and welcome to SAP on Microsoft Azure. My name is Holger Bruchelt, and in this video series, we want to take a look behind the scenes of the Extending SAP Solutions Using Microsoft Power Platform webinar. This is Chapter 9, where we will connect a SharePoint list to our Power App. This is one of the strengths of the Power Platform and Power Apps in particular, that there's a huge list of existing connectors available that allow you to connect to data sources, like the SAP system or the Q&A makers, as we've seen before, but obviously also to SharePoint and a lot of other systems. Actually, connecting to SharePoint is super easy. So we have already our Power App that is now connected to a Q&A maker. We have previously seen how we can connect it to an SAP system. And now we want to really connect it to this huge range of other connectors. And we'll just pick one of them for now. And that's the SharePoint list connector. Connecting there is actually really, really easy. So let's take a look. So we'll start with our Power App. So here, obviously, we have the entry screen, the home screen, that points to our Q&A maker interaction. But we actually also have a SharePoint list. In the SharePoint list, we have a bunch of product documents that could be specifications or something like that. But this list actually not only contains the actual documents, but we also inserted an sold to column that contains certain usernames that, for example, are somehow associated with these documents. Now, back in our Power App, what we want to do is we want to create a virtual gallery. So very much like what we had before when we retrieved the products from the SAP system or when we had the question and answers from our Q&A bot. So here again, we have a virtual gallery. We'll enter a heading to this virtual gallery. And then now what we want to do is we want to connect this virtual gallery to our SharePoint list. So you can see the Q&A maker, you see the chat collection, but now there are a bunch of other connectors there. And what we want to do is we want to use this SharePoint connector. So if I select the SharePoint connector, then I can do this direct connection to the SharePoint Online or part of Office 365. And when I actually look for this, then it automatically retrieves the available sites that are there, the available collections that are there. And the page that I want to connect is this Contoso Web 1, which contains our product documents list. So here is the actual site, Contoso Web 1, product documents, and that's the one that I want to add here to our virtual gallery. Now, immediately when I do this connection, you can already see that some of the data was fetched. So you can see the date, that looks good, but actually this line here is currently empty because it's this item.title. So let me quickly change this. So if I just remove the title and start typing name, then we immediately get the live data from the SharePoint site. So that's already a great start. So now I have this list of all the products that are in my SharePoint site and also accessible or available here in this virtual gallery. Now, maybe I don't want to have this full list here. You can see there are really a lot of documents there, basically all the documents from the SharePoint site. So what I want to do now is I want to actually filter some of the values. So first of all, I can sort it in a certain range, but then what I want to do is I want to filter the results of this full SharePoint list, and I only want to get these documents where this sold to column or the more to say the email field of this sold to column equals the email of the user that is currently using our Power App. Once we have this filtered, then actually we want to sort everything in an ascending order. And now you can see I only have these three products listed, or these three documents listed here in our Power App. And that's exactly here for our Johnny user. We have these 1, 2, 3 products from SharePoint that are now available within a few clicks in our Power App.